Because of Sharon's depth and extensive work, she lived in every environment that she entered. There was not an environment that she did not leave. And we are privileged to experience the fruit of her leadership. My selections from the Sharon Wilson Colden, the Mooring Choir. It's an amalgamation of all the choirs. Let's be blessed by her fruit. Thank you. they make witnesses in the house. They make testimonies in the house. I'm going to know that you know that you know. And I came to meet you with an advance.
Hallelujah!
Senator Francis is coming to share with you a serving a person that has been well loved all over this world.
in celebration of Black History Month. They perform annual fall and spring concerts as well. Sharon works with academic and cultural event series, Director J.T. Harrison, to present gospel music workshops that were open to the public and featured national recording artists such as Jerry Thomas and Reverend Timothy White. Undoubtedly, she impacted many UW students' lives spiritually, musically, and emotionally during her tenure here. Sharon's legacy for gospel music has gone on for 40 years at Baldwin Wallace University, strengthening through the years. My understanding is that she shared her love of music and serves as a choir director for several choirs throughout her life, including the Ohio State Choir, School JC International Choir, the Revelation School of the Arts Choir, just to name a few. Professionally, Sharon was a teacher in Cleveland Public Schools for 19 years and opened the Preparatory Academy of the Revelation School of Arts at the Agape Christian Center. Again, our thoughts are with all those present at her funeral service. We are proud to call Sharon a graduate of Baldwin Wallace University. She has been and will continue to be missed. Sincerely, Robert C. Palmer, President. Condolences from the Potter's House of Dallas, Texas. On behalf of Bishop T. and First Lady Sarita Jakes, the staff of T. Jakes Ministries, and the church family of the Potter's House, do hereby extend our most heartfelt sympathy to our sisters, Evelyn French and Carolyn Sullivan, and the entire family in the passing of your sister Sharon Colden. We would like to acknowledge the outstanding work and commitment that Mrs. Colden displayed as she was a vital part of the Clay Academy staff. It has been said that life is a fragment, a moment between two eternities, influenced by all that has preceded, and to influence all those that follow. Although the loss of a loved one is never easy to bear, the Lord has promised us hope, and that those that sleep in Christ shall rise again. We admonish you to hold to God in changing hand. He is with you. His word decrees that he will never leave nor forsake you. That is the kind of promise that we can rest assured of and will never change. And remember that although absent in the body, we do send our love, support, and prayers that the days ahead will bring added strength and sustain you at this chapter in life comes to a close. Be reminded of one thing, and the peace of God which has all understanding, so keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. May these brief words bring consolation to you given the 7th day of March 2015. Respectfully submitted, Pastor Lawrence Robinson, Associate Pastor, Bishop T.D. Jakes, Senior Pastor. We also have condolences and resolutions from Region 7, Bishop Matthew Norwood, Regional Apostle, Solomon's Temple Church, Bishop Henry Davenport, Pastor, Ohio Diocese Bishop Kim Fitzgerald, Lift Him Up, Bishop Brad Barry and Bishop Fred Rubin, Rehoboth Temple Church of Christ, Apostle Barry, International Youth Department of the Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ, Bishop James May, Apostle to the Youth, and Bishop Reggie Davis, Youth Advisor, and also the family wishes to thank everyone for your cards, condolences, and your prayers are in this heart. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sister Francis, for sharing with us in a different way. God has truly blessed her, and she has blessed the world around her, wherever she finds. Pam Wilson Westbrook is going to share with us in a very unique and innovative way. We want to welcome her to a very exciting part of this celebration of life. Thank you.
But I'll tell you this little off-side of the music. Sharon was an avid game show lover. She challenged me in games, Boggle, Scrabble, and we just had this competition going on. So Sharon loved word games. But if you ever attended any of Sharon's concerts, Sharon grew up in church, and we would talk, and she would say, Pam, well, Peachy, when we said we were saved, we meant we were saved. We didn't experiment. We didn't dibble and dabble. We grew up in the church, and like some celebrities who, and because I consider her a celebrity, they take their gift out elsewhere. But Sharon kept hers right in the church so that she could be a blessing and inspiration. And when she found Jesus, I can hear Myrna Summer singing that, y'all. She found Jesus. And she was glad. And she was determined to walk with Jesus. Oh, yes, she was.